हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ लोहित दलाल, लेक्चरर, इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड कम्युनिकेशन इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट, जैन पॉलिटेक्निक बेलगावी। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस यूनिट नंबर 6, डिजिटल इंटीग्रेटेड सर्किट्स। ओके, इन दिस लेक्चर आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस व्हाट इज डिजिटल इंटीग्रेटेड सर्किट्स, डेफिनेशंस ऑफ फैन इन फैन आउट प्रोपेगेशन डिले, ओके, एंड ऑल्सो लॉजिक फैमिलीज, power dissipation and noise margin, and finally I am going to discuss about summary. Okay, so first, what is digital integrated circuits, okay, and what are the logic families, question arises, right? In a digital system designs, the main objective is to create the integrated circuit. Integrated circuit means miniaturized circuit components are placed in a small space. Okay, so entire circuit is made smaller, okay, and a circuit configuration or the arrangement of the elements in a special manner means we are using some techniques, okay, we'll get a logic family, okay. So there will be a different techniques, different approaches, okay, different types, different methods for making the digital integrated circuits, okay. We are naming it as a logic families, okay, means we are going to make the digital integrated circuits, okay. So there will be a different classifications will be there. First classification, so bipolar families, so next one metal oxide semiconductor families, third one is the hybrid families, okay. So in bipolar families, there will be a diode logic circuits will comes, resistor trans RTL we are naming, and diode transistor logic DTL, okay, transistor logic circuits, okay, and emitter couple logic circuits or a current mode logic circuits, integrated injection logic, okay. So these are all or comes in a bipolar families, okay. So means different methodologies, different circuits we are going to employ, the we are getting through these circuits we are going to make the digital integrated circuits, means miniaturized circuits, okay, that should be occupied in a smaller space, okay. So day by day, however the technology is going on, okay, so technology is changing, technology is going to update, okay, we are going to make the circuit size minimize, okay. So next one is the metal oxide semiconductor families, okay. So there will be a PMOS and NMOS family, okay, P type and N type materials will be there, and complementary MOS family, standard CMOS, okay, and also clocked CMOS, okay, and also BiCMOS, pseudo NMOS, CMOS domino logic, pass transistor logic will be there, okay, and also there will be a next one will be the hybrid CMOS family, okay. So in hybrid families there will be a BiCMOS family will come, means either from bipolar either from that MOSFETs, okay. So next there will be a some concepts, okay, so some definitions, these are in your syllabus they have given, okay. First one, fan in, okay, it determines the number of inputs used in the logic gate can be handled, okay, and also there will be a fan out. The fan out is defined as the maximum number of inputs that can be connected to the output of the gate without degrading the normal operation, okay, and also it is known as the loading factor, okay, means number of input, maximum number of inputs that can be connected to the output of the gate without degrading the normal operation, that is known as a fan out, okay. Next one is the propagation delay. Propagation delay is the time required for the input to be propagated to the output, means whatever the time is needed, okay, from input to output, whatever the time, that is known as a propagation time, propagation delay of a logic gate is also defined as the time taken for the effect to change in the input to the visible output, okay. You are providing the input and you are waiting some time, then you are getting the output, that is a propagation delay. Propagation time, whatever the time required, is known as a propagation delay. Next one is the power dissipation, okay. So in every gate that is connected with the power supply VCC okay, and also VDD in case of the CMOS, okay. So power supply which gets a certain amount of current during the operations, and also each gate can be in a high state transition or a low state transition. There will be different current to be drawn from the power supply, okay, and also there will be a current drawn during the high state, means that is a ICCH, okay. So means there will be a different states, okay, you will get the different currents, okay. For a transistor to transistor logics, the transition current is negligible, okay. So you will get the power so there will be a average power you are going to calculate, okay. So next one is the noise margin, okay. Noise margin means there will be a gate circuits are to be constructed and sustain variations in the input and output voltage levels, okay. So means variations are usually gives the several different factors. Batteries lose their full potential, causing the supply voltage drop, okay. So that is the noise margin, okay. And also for high operating temperatures may give the drift in the transistor voltage and current characteristics, okay. That is the spurious pulses may be introduced in a signal, okay, and also current in a neighboring supplies, okay. So that is also all about the noise margin, and also the all gates are designed to tolerate the certain amount of noise, okay, certain amounts of disturbance, okay, on their input and output ports. The maximum noise voltage level that is tolerated by the gate, okay, maximum number of disturbance that can be tolerated by the gate at the input and output ports, that is known as the noise margin, okay. So that is about the noise margin, okay. So in this session we have discussed what is logic family. The main objective is to make the circuit size minimum, okay, means you are going to integrate the circuits, okay. That is comes in a logic families classification. We studied bipolar, MOS and hybrid families, okay, definitions of fan in and fan out and propagation delay, power dissipation and noise margins, okay. Thank you.